In this video, we're going to continue transforming our basic sine and cosine wave. This time we're going to focus on transforming the period and the phase shift of our function. Let's go back to our basic sine function. We have f of x is equal to a sine bx plus c plus d. And we've already talked about how the a affects the amplitude and how the d affects the vertical shift. Well, now we're going to talk about b and c. Those are going to affect this function horizontally instead of vertically. Let's look at a function such as sine of 2x, and let's see how that affects our period of the function. Let's look at the first point at f of 0. Well, if we plug 0 into x, we get sine of 2 times 0, or sine of 0. Well, I know what the sine of 0 is, that is simply the point 0, and I've graphed that on my graph. Let's look at pi over 2. If I plug pi over 2 into my function sine of 2x, then I get sine of 2 times pi over 2, or sine of pi. I also know what sine of pi is equal to. Sine of pi is equal to 0. Well, this is looking a little bit odd. If we continue and look at pi, if I have f of pi, that's equal to sine of 2 pi, which again is equal to 0. This doesn't look much like a sine function. Well, let's look at the point pi over 4. If I put pi over 4 into my function, then I have sine of 2 times pi over 4, or sine of pi over 2. Well, sine of pi over 2 is equal to positive 1. So for the function sine 2x, if I plug in pi over 4, I get the value 1. Likewise, if I look at the point 3 pi over 4, and I put that into sine 2x, then I find that the function of 3 pi over 4 is equal to sine of 3 pi over 2, which was equal to negative 1. And if I connect my dots, my function looks something like this. What's happened is my period, instead of going from 0 to 2 pi, now it only takes from 0 to pi to complete a cycle. So my period is contracted. This looks squished together compared to what it was before. Let's look at a different function. Let's look at sine of 1 half x. Again, if I look at x equals 0 and plug that into my function, I again get sine of 0, or 0. So that point hasn't changed. However, now if I look at pi over 2 and plug it into my function, sine of 1 half times pi over 2 is equal to sine of pi over 4, that was square root of 2 over 2, or approximately equal to 0.7071. Let's look at f of pi. Well, if I plug pi into my sine of 1 half x, then I get sine of 1 half pi, which was equal to 1. Continuing on, if x equals 3 pi over 2, I have sine of 1 half times 3 pi over 2, or sine of 3 pi over 4. Sine of 3 pi over 4 is also equal to 0.7071. And if I continue on to 2 pi, the sine of 1 half times 2 pi is simply equal to sine of pi, or 0. And if I connect the dots, we can see that now instead of taking from 0 to 2 pi, it's going to take from 0 to 4 pi before I complete a single cycle. So having sine of 1 half x, instead of contracting my period, it's now expanding my period, again along the horizontal axis. Let's look at this in general. If we have our sine function in the form of a sine bx plus c plus d, then we can say when the absolute value of b is greater than 1, we will have a horizontal contraction, and the function will expand when the absolute value of b is between 0 and 1. In general, if I ask you what the period of a sine or cosine function is, it's equal to 2 pi divided by the absolute value of b. Again, that's if the function is in the form a sine bx plus c plus d. To be honest, I'm not very good at memorizing formulas, so instead of memorizing that the period is 2 pi over b, what I do is I say, alright, whatever my bx is, I'm going to take the absolute value of bx, because our period is a distance, so that's always going to be a positive value. So I'll take my bx and I'll set it equal to 2 pi, because I remember that for a basic sine function or a basic cosine function, my period is 2 pi. So I'll set bx equal to 2 pi and simply solve for x. For instance, if we go back to our first example of sine of 2x, I set 2x equal to 2 pi. If I divide both sides by 2, then I get x is equal to pi. And we found that. We found that the period of the function sine 2x was equal to pi. So let's see how this works for sine of 1/2x. Again, I'll take 1/2x, set that equal to 2 pi, since 2 pi is my normal period. I'll multiply both sides by 2, and now I find that x is equal to 4 pi, or my period is equal to 4 pi. So we've talked about A, B, and D. Well, what is this plus C going to do? Well, this plus C is going to affect something that we're going to call a phase shift. Just like D shifted this function vertically, this phase shift is going to shift our function horizontally from left to right. But it won't just be C that affects things. We're also going to still have to look at B. Well, let's look at this function to start off with. F of x is equal to sine of x minus pi divided by 2. Let's look at point F equals 0. Alright, that's sine of 0 minus 2 pi, or sine of negative pi over 2. Alright, to remember what the sine of negative pi over 2 is, I'm going to go back to my unit circle. Remember, a negative angle is one with a clockwise rotation, and a rotation of negative pi over 2 ends up at 3 pi over 2. And that leads us to a sine of negative 1. Remember, the sine is the y value. So if I go back and say f of 0, that means is negative 1, and we'll plot that point. Let's look at pi over 2 and put that into our function. Well, then I'd have sine of pi over 2 minus pi over 2, or sine of 0. Well, I know what sine of 0 is, that's still equal to 0, and I'll plot that point there at the point pi over 2. If I look at pi, then I'll have sine of pi minus pi over 2, which equals sine of pi over 2, and sine of pi over 2 was equal to positive 1. Moving on to 3 pi over 2, again I'll subtract pi over 2 from that, I'll get 2 pi over 2, and the sine of 2 pi over 2, well that's just the sine of pi, which is equal to 0. And lastly, I'll look at 2 pi. Sine of 2 pi minus pi over 2 is equal to sine of 3 pi over 2, and the sine of 3 pi over 2 was equal to negative 1. Connecting the dots, we see that this entire function, it looks exactly the same, except we've shifted it 90 degrees to the right. So here more completely we see our original function is just shifted to the right by pi over 2. Keep in mind some students are confused by the fact that this is sine of x minus pi over 2, which might lead you to think that this function should actually shift to the left, but it does not. However, if we wanted to plot sine of x plus pi over 2, well, quite frankly, I'm getting tired of plotting all these points one by one, and I think you're probably tired of watching, so please believe me when I say that if I graph sine of x plus pi over 2, it's going to shift it pi over 2, but this time to the left instead of the right. I can do this in general. The phase shift will be to the right when negative c over b is greater than 0. The phase shift will be to the left when negative c over b is less than 0. Again, I have a slightly easier way of remembering this, and that is to find the phase shift, I'm just going to take my bx plus c, set it equal to 0, and then solve for x, and that will give me my phase shift. If I look at my general sine function, and say I want to look at my first example of sine x minus pi over 2. In this case, first of all, I have to figure out what my b and my c are. Well, my b is equal to 1, and my c is equal to negative pi over 2. So if I try to find what negative c over b is, let's see, that would be negative pi over 2 divided by 1, or negative pi over 2, or simply positive pi over 2. That would mean we would shift this to the right by pi over 2, which is what we found. Again, I have an easier time doing this by setting x minus 2 pi equal to 0. I set this equal to 0 because that's my normal phase shift. There usually is no phase shift in my basic sine function. So I set this bx plus c equal to 0, I'd add pi over 2 to both sides, and I would get x equals pi over 2. That means we have a phase shift of 90 degrees, or pi over 2. So that would shift to the right by pi over 2. Again, you can do this either way. You can either memorize the phase shift to the right or left, depending on negative c over b, or you can set bx plus c equal to 0 and simply solve for x and shift it by that amount. Again, if I looked at my other function where I had sine x plus pi over 2, I'd set that equal to 0. Subtracting pi over 2 from both sides, I'd find that my phase shift is equal to negative pi over 2. And that would mean a shift to the left by pi over 2. And there we've finished transforming our basic sine and cosine wave. We've talked about transforming the period, as well as transforming the phase shift.